Hey, y'all, I just wanted to talk about logical reasoning and reasoning, logical reasoning questions. Okay, this is going to be my very, very, very last video on this channel about the LSAT, in-depth LSAT information. Check out my other channel. I'll leave a link down below in the description box, but I wanted to talk about the logical reasoning questions on the law school admission test, the LSAT. You know, the LSAT is 5 sections, and logical reasoning makes up 2 sections, so it's a big part of the exam. I'm on the LSAT website. Check and see. All right, it says, arguments are a fundamental part of the law, and analyzing arguments is a key element of legal analysis. Training in the law builds on a foundation of basic reasoning skills. Law students must draw on the skills of analyzing, evaluating, constructing, and refuting arguments. They need to be able to identify, you can see that, identify reasoning and that sort of thing. They need to be able to reconcile opposing positions and use arguments to persuade others. Now, there are some strategies that y'all can use. Make sure you look for those keywords, like what most strengthens the argument after you read the premise and things like that. For each question, which best supports it, which make sure you know what the question is asking for. Like, if it's asking for weakening information, what best weakens the argument, you don't want to pick out something that sounds right and it actually strengthens it. So yeah, guys, I just wanted to give those quick tips to you guys as far as that is concerned. And also, like I said, I'm on the law school admission council website, and it says these skills, it's talking about logical reasoning. These skills include recognizing parts of an argument and their relationships, recognizing similarities, differences between patterns and reasoning. And then also, guys, make sure when you're studying for the LSAT, you're using the official books for the LSAT, the official prep test books. And I showed y'all that before here on my channel. Make sure you check out my other LSAT videos here on this channel, and then go over to my other channel for more in-depth, more detailed information about the LSAT and strategies and that sort of thing. So yeah, those are the best books. And then also, you can use PowerScore. PowerScore is good. I talked about their webinars. They have some free webinars.